In this video, I'm going to show you how you can set up a Fiverr account, F-I-V-E-R-R, yes, a Fiverr account. Now, if you have a skill in this digital world and you actually want to grow faster and you want to give this skill out to different people that actually need your services, Fiverr should be your number one aim, because there are millions and billions of people on Fiverr that are ready to pay you for the jobs and services you render online. Now, in this video, I'm going to be taking you step by step on how you can create a Fiverr account and how you can set up your profile to attract more individuals on the Fiverr internet space. Okay, so right now I'm going to show you step by step how you can do this yourself. Since you have a skill or you don't have a skill, I will be treating that in this video. All I want in exchange right now is to please like this video, subscribe to the channel, and most especially turn on the bell notification so YouTube can notify you whenever I upload any valuable content like what you are about to watch right now. So I'm waiting for you to like this video. So thank you for liking. So let's proceed with the tutorial of today. Get started. Go to your browser and type in www.fiverr.com. So you're going to be brought into this interface. Just click on any of which. So it's going to direct you over to Fiverr account. Now, the next thing you want to do, since you're actually using a mobile device to create your Fiverr account, come down to anywhere you can actually see the hamburger icon, then click view desktop site. So what this will actually do is that it's going to give you a display of your Fiverr account, just like the way you are going to have it on a desktop version. Okay, so once this is done, the next thing you want to do right now is to come over to where it says join here. Don't have an account, just click on join here, and it's going to ask you to continue with a Google account or to continue with an email address. So just come over to continue with an email address, and I'm going to be putting this right here. Then the next thing you want to do right now is to put in a password. Okay, and so right now you can actually see that I've put in an email address and a password, so I'm just going to click on continue. Now it's going to ask you to choose a username. Now it's advisable you put in a username depending on what you actually want to do on this Fiverr account. So let me just go with a username of UC Edit. Okay, let me see if this username can go. So you can actually see that I just inserted this as UC Edit. I can actually use this particular profile for editing of videos. Okay, or you can just say, let's say UC underscore video edit. Okay, so actually we can say this can go. So just come down and click on create my account. Now a confirmation mail will be sent to you. All you have to do is to enter that code right here just to confirm your account. This is the mail we got from Fiverr just to confirm our account. You can either go ahead to copy this code and go back to your Fiverr account and confirm your account. So what we are going to do right now is to paste this code right here, and we are going to come down right here and click on submit. So once we go ahead clicking on submit, we are going to get our Fiverr account. So right now you can actually see that they said UC video edit, your account has been created, what brings you to Fiverr. Okay, now there are two things that can actually bring you over to Fiverr. We have being a client on Fiverr. Being a client means you want to order for freelance services, that is, you want to pay people for the job you want them to do, or you either apply as a freelancer looking to offer your service and you're going to get paid. So the second one is actually what we actually want to do in this profile. We actually want to render services to people on Fiverr so we can get paid. So you're going to click this and you're going to click on next. Now it says, what type of freelancer are you? A side hustle, a solo freelancer, agency employee, agency owner. So you either go for a side hustle or a solo freelancer. So right now I'm just going for a side hustle. Okay, so right now I'm going to click on next. Now it says, what's your freelancing experience? I'm just getting started, freelancing online, freelancing offline, both online and offline. Okay, so for the first time, you can just go ahead and click on I am just getting started, and you're going to be brought to this interface. Now it says, great, you are almost there. Here is what next: complete your freelancer profile, create your gig, publish it, and start selling. You can see how straightforward this is. It says complete your freelancer profile, create your first gig, publish it, and start selling. So a gig is like a niche, what you actually want to offer on your Fiverr account. So take note, when creating your Fiverr account, you should know what a gig is. A gig is just like you putting out what you want to offer as a freelancer. So what we are going to do right now is to come down to where it says start exploring or complete your freelancer profile. So it's advisable to come down and click on complete your freelancer profile, and it's going to bring you over to your profile where you have to set up your account. Now it says ready to start selling on Fiverr. Here has some breakdowns: learn what makes a successful profile, create your seller profile, publish your gig. So you can go ahead to play this video right now and get to understand some little things. And the next page says, what makes successful Fiverr profile? Your first impression matters. Create a profile that will stand out from the crowd on Fiverr. Take your time in creating your profile so it's exactly as you want it to be. So what this is actually explaining to you is that it wants you to make your profile stand out so clients can actually contact you when they see the professionalism in your profile. So what we're going to do right now is to click on continue. You can just go through all this, but click on continue. Now you are on your profile. This is where we actually want to do the main job and the main important thing that will actually skyrocket your profile to your desired audience. Now when you look at your profile, you can actually see that the completion rate is on 25%. So right now what you're going to do is to impute your first name right here and impute your last name right here. Then come down to where it says display name. Now you're going to put in a display name. This name is what will be displayed to your audience. So actually, I've been working on mobile sites. For you to have your desktop view, all you just have to do is to come right here and click on view desktop, and you're going to be viewing this in the desktop form. So right now you can actually see that you can zoom in and zoom out this right here. So right now we were on our display name. So after putting your display name, you can just come down to where it says a profile picture. Now you have to put in a professional picture just to make your profile look professional. Now under description, they said share a bit about your work experience, cool projects you have completed, and your area of expertise. Okay, so you can be professional enough to write something like this. I wrote, I am Coach Joaquin, a skilled and creative video editor with a passion for turning raw footage into captivating visual stories. Whether you are a content creator, business owner, or brand looking to make your videos stand out, I am here to help you deliver high quality, engaging content that gets results. Okay, so right now you can actually see that this actually gave me what I actually wanted as a video editor on this particular profile of my Fiverr account. Now you can come right here and add languages of which you can speak, of which you understand also. So we are going to select English right here, and we are going to come right here. You can also add the level of your language. Now we can just come right here and pick French, and you're going to add this as well. Okay, so once you do that, just click on add, and this will be added to what you have actually selected. So right now you can actually see that I didn't fill out all these things, but because of time, I just want to go through all this. So what I'm going to do right now, let me quickly put in the first name, and let me put in the display name. Let's put our display name to be this. Let's make this so let's just add this. So you can actually see that we've actually added you've added your first name, your last name, put in your display name, and you can just come right here and put in your profile picture. Now we have actually added the description and our language. And so right now let's go ahead to add a profile picture right here. Let's just add something over to this account. So let's just add this. So let's add this as one of our profile picture. So once we are done with this, the next thing we want to do right now, I think we've filled out all this, is to come right here and click on continue. So we just have to continue. Now we're going to be brought into this next page. This next page actually wants you to fill out your occupation, your skill, your education, certification, personal website, if you have any. Then you're going to come down and click on continue. Okay, so what we are going to do right now is to come down to where it says your occupation. So actually, what do you want to do? Digital marketing, graphic design, writing and translation, business program, music and audio, video and animation. So we just have to come down to video and animation. Now they said choose 2 to 5 of the best skill in video and animation. So right now we are going to choose social media videos and we are going to come down to choose maybe video editing. Okay, so that is that for that. And we're going to come down on that skill. We are going to put in a skill right here, video editing. So you can just go ahead putting in any of which you want to go for. Experience level, we are going to come right here and put in expert. Then we are going to add this thing. Then we are going to add this. Then the next thing you want to do right now is to come down under education. And you're going to be putting your university and fill out all these, your title, your country or college and university, put in your college. Then we are going to come right here also and we are going to put in certification if you have any, and you are going to add your personal website if you have any also. Then after that you come down and click on continue. So now you have to fill out all this. Make sure you have added your years of experience, your strongest skill. So right now we just have to come right here and fill out all this. So your country of college, you just have to come right here and put in Nigeria. Title should be BSc. And your college, just come right here and put in the name of your university. So once you've actually added all these details, the name of your university, the college name, the year and other vital information, you can just come down right here and put in awards certified from year to year if you have any. Now they are asking you to put in a personal website, that is if you actually have one. So fill out information rightly on your account. Then once you're done with all these filling, just come down right here and click on continue. And you're going to be brought into the next interface that says account security. Now this is for your security purpose, just to keep your account safe. You can actually see a private email and a private phone number. This is actually best known to you. This is actually what you'll be seeing on your account. This is not a public display. So this is actually your personal information, your professional information and your account setting. Now what you actually want to do when you get this is just to come down to where it says continue. So what you just want to do is to click on continue and you'll be asked, are you ready to start selling on Fiverr? So what you just have to do is to create a gig. Now it says a great time to join Kickstart, our program for freelancers who are new to Fiverr. Access the benefits you need to help you get your first order faster. Kickstart your business and other valuable things right here. So what you have to do right now is not to click on join now, but to click on create a gig. Okay, so right now to create a gig is very simple and I'm going to be explaining what a gig is on Fiverr. A gig on Fiverr is actually what you want to sell. Okay, so what you actually want to do, your niche, what you want to provide services for, what you actually want to give out to your audience is actually a gig. Now you can actually see, I will do something I am really good at. What you can actually write here as an editor is that you can write, I will help you edit a professional video for anything for this, for that. So depending on how you want your gig to be. Okay, you can just type in, I will help you create a video, I will help you edit a professional video. So this is actually what you want to offer. Now under category, you can actually see they said choose the category and subcategory most suitable for your gig. Now when you come down to select this, you're going to be seeing graphic design, digital marketing, writing translation, video and animation, music audio, and so many right here. You can go ahead to choose a video and animation. Come right here and select the subcategory. Now, under subcategory, you can put in anything of your choice just to tally with what you actually chosen as your own category. Now, when you come down to search tags, these tags are actually what is searchable. When someone actually types these particular keywords, your profile will actually display. So these search tags are actually keywords that are related to your gig. For an example, what is related to this gig is video editing and the likes of others. So once you're done filling out this gig, you are going to be coming down right here to come down right here and save and continue. So once you are done saving and continue, your account will be created perfectly for audience to view and see the services you render on your account. Now, this is the easiest way to create a Fiverr account using just your mobile phone. Now, if you don't have a skill, I'm going to teach you a skill and also write out a gig for you, just for you to make your first sales on Fiverr. All you have to do right now is to like this video, subscribe to this channel, and most especially turn on the bell notification. Then the next thing for you to do is to click the second link on the pinned comment section, and you're going to be getting access to my Telegram channel, or better see my WhatsApp group. I can actually show you some things to know about getting a skill and also creating a Fiverr gig on your account. And so thank you for watching this video to this point. I hope you got value from it, and if you did, please do well to like this video, subscribe to the channel, and most especially turn on the bell notification so YouTube can notify you whenever I upload any valuable content like what you just watched. See you on my next video, and keep winning.